Hey y'all, it's Erica Bane back again with another Love Victor breakdown. In this video, we are talking about season 2. Shout out to Emily Powell, television critic over at ericabane.com for breaking down season 2. Now that season 2 of Hulu's Love Victor has dropped, it's time to talk about all the new relationship drama we get to see this season. From adorable moments between Victor and his now boyfriend Benji to fights between every character in sight, this season has a lot of things to talk about. It opens where season 1 left off, with Victor telling his family that he's gay. Pilar reacts wonderfully, giving her brother a hug and telling him she loves him. His parents, not so much. Armando seems mostly confused, but Isabel looks disgusted. Between this and the separation, parental strife is a major theme of this season. It only gets worse from there. After a time skip, this season begins at the end of summer. Victor and Benji are now in a committed relationship, and man, are they adorable. But Isabel doesn't think so. She can barely stand and look at her son anymore, refuses to have Benji over, and refuses to admit that Victor has a boyfriend to anyone, especially Victor's younger sibling, Adrain. Homophobia is not a good look on her. But not everything is bad. Lake, Felix, Benji, and Victor have gotten close over the summer, and their friendship is heartwarming. The chemistry in this cast is really amazing. I truly believe that they all care for each other. Unfortunately though, our wonderful Mia had decided to run away to summer camp this summer, cut off all contact with her school friends, and came back a complete fifth wheel. I truly do feel for her. Watching her struggle through this isolation is a gut punch, but I do not agree with the revolving door of bad decisions she makes this season. If last season was all about internal validation, season 2 deals with the fact that you can't change the way others see you. From nasty rumors started about Mia and Victor's breakup at Creekwood High to a pastor telling Victor he's going to hell, there's a lot of themes of external validation to see here. What I found most interesting was how this season explored what societal pressures can do to relationships. Benji and Victor, though they had the perfect summer, begin crumbling as soon as the school year rolls around because their new relationship is put under the spotlight. Victor refuses to come out to the school and they fight. Victor comes out, gets kicked out of the boys' locker room, and they fight. Benji tries to act cool around his friends but ends up hurting Victor in the process, and guess what? They fight. All of this is because of pressure that society puts on them to act a certain way or do a certain thing. And this is not the only relationship that falls prey to that. Felix and Lake have been in a pretty adorable relationship through the entirety of the second season, but Felix is dealing with some trouble at home. It's revealed in the first season that his mom, Dawn, has manic depression, and is expanded upon in this season when we find out that she's been in a depressive episode for months and no longer can take care of herself. Because of this, she lost her job and rent is past due. Felix tries his best to be the provider for the house, but the boy is a teenager, and writing people's essays for them in exchange for cash is just not cutting it. So Lake, trying to be the supportive girlfriend, steps in. She tells her mom about what Felix has been going through, and her mom makes a welfare check just to make sure things are okay. Things are not okay. Felix is embarrassed that he cannot hide his situation as well as he was supposed to, and takes it out on Lake, accusing her of breaking his trust and ultimately breaking things off of her. Dawn, embarrassed that anyone saw her like this, storms into Lake's mom's place of work and has a complete mental break, ending up committed in a hospital on a psychiatric hold. Critics note, Emily felt as though the portrayal of the mental illness could have been handled a little more delicately, and the effects that Dawn's manic depression had on everyone around her and the societal stigmas of it all were fairly done. She definitely cried during this subplot. Lake might have broken Felix's trust, but you know who hasn't? Pilar. Between giving up Billie Eilish concert tickets to help Felix with his rent, to staying up late watching quiz shows with him when he's sad about his mom, our girl has a crush. And it just might be reciprocated if that kiss at the end is any indication. Speaking of new love interests, our boy Victor seems to have found himself in a love triangle again. Benji and Victor on the rocks this entire season, not for lack of trying, mind you. Like season 1, season 2 is full of amazing conversations trying to hash out the relationship issues, but it's just not working. This new boy, Raheem, is not helping things. Raheem is one of Pilar's friends and comes to Victor for advice about coming out to his Muslim family. Sparks don't immediately fly, but Raheem is quickly becoming one of Victor's closest friends and confidants. Victor tells his boy everything. Even things about Benji that he was told to never tell anyone. I mean, Victor, come on. Trust is given and it can be taken away, and of course, Benji takes it away. As soon as it's revealed that Victor told his deepest, darkest secrets to someone who basically is a stranger to Benji, the golden couple goes on a break, and who does Victor run to? Raheem. Don't get me wrong, Raheem is a sweetie and I'm all for seeing where their relationship goes if there is a relationship to be had. I'm just angry about how it started. Raheem decides that Victor needs a day of pampering that's completely Benji free, so they play hooky from school. They get to go to lunch, they get to go get their nails done, and have existential conversation about being perceived as mass versus femme, and how society treats you based on both. Truly an adorable date. Except Benji and Victor aren't broken up yet. They're just on a break. Victor, the pattern of emotional cheating is starting to concern me. Anyways, Raheem and Victor in their night at a gay club singing a love ballad to each other, and at this point, I give up. Their voices are amazing, but come on guys, either break up with Benji and move on or put some serious boundaries into place. Well, good news, Victor's mom Isabel puts those boundaries up for them after she catches them at the gay club. Apparently, Victor left his location on his phone. Rule number one for sneaking out, kiddo, turn that thing off. Victor's mom has gone through an incredible journey this season along with her recently separated husband. The audience gets to watch as she grapples with her prejudice she's internalized as a child. Starting off this season with all but banning Victor's boyfriend from her home and ending it by telling off a priest, quitting her job at the church, and trying to get Victor and Benji back together. Her husband, Armando, has a similar arc, starting off the season being very uncomfortable around Victor and ending it by being a vocal member of the local P-Flag chapter, parents, friends, and family of lesbians and gays, and finding a way to be settled in his own machismo and being the father of a gay son. Because of the character growth, we get to see these parents come back together at the end of the season, awkwardly asking each other to share a pint of ice cream like it's their first date all over again. Oh, but if you was hoping for reconciliation for any of the other broken up couples at the end of the season, I have some bad news for you. You're gonna have to wait for season 3 to see what happens to it all. Because the finale of season 2 leaves us with all these questions and no answers. First of all, we see Mia, who has some mysterious emails from the mother who abandoned her throughout the show, taking off in a car to go meet her for the first time. And then there's Lake, asked on something that's definitely a date by a woman. She says yes, and I'm on the edge of my seat waiting to see where this goes. Felix kisses Pilar at the apartment building, and Raheem confesses his feelings to Victor right in front of Benji, leaving the boy stuck wondering which man should he choose. Apparently, he decides because he takes off running towards a house. We watch with bated breath as the door opens and nothing fades to black. I guess we have to stay tuned for season 3. Like season 1, season 2 of Love, Victor had me laughing, crying, and shaking my head over all of these characters. It is dramatic and wholesome all at once. If you haven't watched already, check it out on Hulu right now. And again, happy Pride, everyone. I keeps